Wait till the floods go down. But really, you can't imagine how beautiful it is to be here with all the water around. So we're going to go paddling on a tour so you can see just what it's like in Mayapur during the floods. There's also a Facebook page with good photographs. Is that the Mayapur.com Facebook page?
TV.
Which one?
Mayapur TV.
The Mayapur TV Facebook page?
Yeah.
Okay. So if you look at Mayapur TV Facebook page, you can see lots of photographs. It was great fun coming here. The bus went to the local village, and then in Bamanpukur, and then we had to come the rest of the way by a three-wheeler, which the flood water is just below the level of the three-wheeler, and people were fishing in the middle of the road. This boat we're in is already capsized once, and if you're watching this video, I just assume that we didn't capsize and fall in with the camera. You capsized before, yeah? But your camera was in a waterproof bag. Okay. Everybody's in a very jolly mood. Nobody's feeling bad about the flood because I think everybody's off work at the moment. They can't do any work. So rather than worry about their pension and their security, they're just having a great time in the flood, and tomorrow will worry about itself. So they're already doing the cleanup. That's amazing. You're doing the cleanup, are you? Okay. You can see the high water mark in the building. We're down about 1.5 feet from where it was at its highest. The water's already come down. So it was built just so the devotees can get direct access from the Now that man's got a proper boat. Our boat actually was made out of a corrugated iron roof. Do you want to show the... Who made this boat? Okay, Nisringa's dad, he's got the camera. His dad made this boat. And if you look at it, it's a corrugated iron roof that he hammered together with some wood. And it looks like it's backwards. It's got the back of the boat at the front and the pointy end at the back. It's actually quite interesting. How long did it take your dad to make it?
One day only.
Just one day. He did all this by hand?
Yeah.
He did all by hand in one day. Beautiful work. Just look at the nails. Look at the nails in them. And it's watertight. It's always a plus. Okay. These buildings, this is the famous wall. These buildings you're looking at now, all these rooms, they were made during Srila Prabhupada's time, about when the long building was made. And a lot of the Bangladeshi devotees used to live here. And the Western devotees we'd live in the nice lotus building, the big building, where first one Prabhupada built, which had nice accommodation. And one day Srila Prabhupada came along the came inside, and he found that in the corner of his veranda somebody had spat out some sugarcane pulp, and he was very upset, and he said, who did it? And he couldn't find out who did it, so he sent all the Western devotees to live in the wall. So it was very nice to live there. So we were all sent out. We actually think the person who was chewing the sugarcane juice was a South Indian Brahmin called Shastri. It wasn't one of us, but we never found out. This is the Bhajan Kutir, Prabhupada's Bhajan Kutir. You can see it's well underwater. They say it'll take about 10 days to clear the flood water. It's already going down. I don't know if you can hear the birds in the background. Quite a lot of bird noises. It really is very peaceful. And everybody's very happy. Okay. Okay. What's business like today? Business, Balo?
Today.
Is good business?
Clinic room.
Oh, sorry. Okay. There's a Jagannath hand loom. That's where I get all my clothes from. Just to repaint, okay. I'll get the fella to wave at us. Have you got him? This one there on the balcony. It's all the Maharaja's samadhis. Who's in there? You've got Sridhar Maharaj, Bhakti Chitra Maharaj,
Kamalakrishna Maharaj,
This is Sri Dham Mayapur, where every grain of dust is from the spiritual world. every step is a song. No, every step is a dance. Every word is a song. And these trees, they're all wish-fulfilling trees. You can get anything you desire just from the trees. And here comes Mother Ganges, is flooding the place. And Prabhupada said, as the world is getting flooded with love of Krishna, so Ganges comes and floods Sridham Mayapur. And it's nice that we're getting this flood just in time for ISKCON's 50th anniversary coming up on August the 13th. This Thursday, the flood should still be here. I think this is our first flood in Mayapur for maybe 10 years. About 10 years since we had a flood.
Last time was 2006.
Last time was 2006. So we're getting a flood now just before the 50th anniversary of ISKCON, which is very, very good sign. So we're going to broadcast that. We've hired Netaji Subhash Stadium in Calcutta. It's a very big venue. And there's devotees from, I think, 108 different countries in the world going to be performing different activities there. And the biggest number of Maharajas in one place ever, I think. There's going to be a very special event. And so here the Ganges has come to pay our respects to Radha Madhava and Lord Nrisingadev. Now you can see the big dome. This wonderful temple, because Ambarish Ford has donated the lion's share of the money for it, being one of Srila Prabhupada's most famous Western devotees, this temple will always be remembered. Srila Prabhupada will always be remembered for this temple, because one of his most famous Western disciples actually was behind the building of it. That was Ambarish Ford, which is a very nice arrangement of Lord Krishna to do that. If any other person had come up with the money, it wouldn't have been the same. Okay, we're coming to the end of the tour. I wish you knew how you probably feel how wonderful, peaceful and rejuvenating it is just to actually be able to see the beauty of Mayapur. And it's such an unusual experience to be able to go by boat around the place, and it's just like a different. It's just such a nice experience. So much wildlife as well, lots of birds singing, which you probably don't catch on the microphone. And it's just a very beautiful mood. So don't remember, there's never a bad time to come to Mayapur. It's always wonderful.
Where did Matthew go?
Take a shot up, smell the boat.
Where did you guys go?